So hi everybody and welcome in. We've got a very special guest today all the way from Toronto in Canada, Mike Tanev. What a thrill for you to see your horse win the Oaks in Invercargill at the weekend.
Yeah, first of all, thanks for having me on. I mean, it's obviously my first stakes win. You know, I've been an owner for a couple of years. I've been involved, you know, for a real long time. And I've always enamored the Southern horses, and it's just something that, you know, I always wanted to get into. And I guess I'm fortunate, you know, that I have a horse like Aardie's Express, you know, as my first stakes winner down there.
It was probably running at about midnight your time, but worth the wait to stay up and watch.
Yeah, midnight our time and nervous all day. I mean, it was just one of those things that, you know, even friends of mine were saying, I'm in the car business up here, and, you know, people were saying, like, you're not right today. And I was going on. I said, well, you know, I got a big race at midnight tonight in New Zealand. I said, for 50,000. I said, that's, you know, I said, I've been real, real, real nervous.
You had no reason to be, as Aardie's Express made it 6 wins from 7 starts.
But it's all Aardie's Express. She's a stunner, and she's a Southern Oaks winner. She won it easily.
Tanev confirming the star filly is here to stay.
Aardie's Express is not going anywhere. She's staying in New Zealand. She's never coming to Canada, because I think the residual value of her now, and you know having won that race and having, you know, fortunate enough to win as much as she had so far, I think her residual value is pretty good down in New Zealand. So I think I've made the decision basically just to keep her there.
Well, if she's not going to Canada, you'll have to come to New Zealand to watch your race.
Oh, definitely going to come. As a matter, it's just not going to be sooner than later. I mean, I will be down there, but it'll probably be a couple of years yet before I get down there. I mean, it's you know, it's 24 hours on a flight, I think the flight is, and I've had 3 back operations, so I don't do too well when I'm confined to a spot. How's that?
Tanev bought Aardie's Express and her dam Tatiana Bromack off Gavel House for a touch under $80,000. Now he also has Aardie Express's full brother Aardie's Flash and full sister Aardie B. Mickey.
I watch replays, like, you know, generally a couple hours a day type of thing, and I was really, really, really intrigued by the mother, Tatiana Bromack. Obviously, always be Mickey. I mean, I don't have anything, you know, he's the fastest horse in the world. But I was intrigued more by the mother, because she had to race against Carabella all the time. And she's probably, you know, if she wasn't your greatest mare down there, she certainly was one of. And this Tatiana Bromack could never beat this horse. And I said, boy, did she ever get some bad trips in some of those races. And I said, it must be a quality mare. So, you know what, I guess the old saying is Columbus took a chance and, you know, discovered America. So I said, you know, I take a chance on this one here.
And it was, your hunch was right.
Well, I mean, right so far. How's that? I've got, you know, the brother, the sister, the mother, and the mother now is enfolded down by the seaside.
So you're all in.
Yeah. I didn't start in the shallow end. I dove right into the deep end.
So the favorites strolled around the outside.
All the horses that I own down there are Aardie, okay? And everyone's probably wondering, you know, who's Aardie? Well, I'm Aardie. I mean, Aardie's me. Aardie was my nickname in baseball. You know, when I used to play, all my buddies, that was a nickname they gave me, Aardie. And it stuck with me all my life. And so I said, you know what? All these farms have a certain name with them wherever you go. So I just created everything Aardie.
And why did they call you Aardie? Where did that come from?
Aardie the Aardvark. If you look at the size of my nose, you can see why. You know, I have a good trotter with Derek Ball, that Aardie by the Hill. You know, he's won 5 races as well. And, you know, he was just another one of these things. Derek sent me a video of the horse in the paddock, and I just looked at the horse in the paddock just basically floating around. Every stride he was doing, he was like, it wasn't even touching the ground. I said, man, I got to buy this horse. And I did a deal with Derek and his owner, and, you know, the horse made it to the races. And, you know, and so far, you know, he's turned out to be pretty good.
Boy, this has been a big win. Aardie by the Hill to beat Errol Deave.
Because I own every horse by myself except for Fabrizio, which I bought, you know, from Cran Dalgetty. And he's up here, and I have 2 partners with that horse. But I tend to go it alone, because, you know, if you make a decision, it's your decision. And whether it's right or wrong, it's your decision.
Just tell us about your tally. How many horses have you owned over the years, and how many have you got at the moment, and where are they?
Well, I got into the business as a gambler in 1978. When I was still in high school, I, you know, a buddy of mine that I used to play baseball with took me to the racetrack one night, and I fell in love with it. And I had one horse in, I want to say 1980, a share of a horse, a pacer, wasn't very good, and didn't do anything until the last 2 years, until I bought Bushman. And ever since I bought Bushman, I think between New Zealand, Australia, and Canada, and now I'm racing in the United States, there's probably been about 30 between all the countries, probably about 30 horses, maybe a little bit more than that.
So, I mean, does your racing business, if you like, does that make money, or does it pay for itself, or is it subsidized by the work in the car industry?
No, it's I guess I think I'm either even or just up a little bit over the 2 years. So really, I've sustained myself.
Ice hockey is also huge for Tanev. Two of his sons, Brandon and Chris, both have lucrative contracts in the NHL. They play for Seattle and the Calgary Flames.
I support any team that my sons are playing for. And if they're playing against each other, I hope for a good game and no one gets hurt.
And the Maple Leafs, are they your team of choice or not?
Never, ever were. Born and raised here in Toronto, 62 years old, and the Toronto Maple Leafs were never, ever my team. Detroit Red Wings were always my favorite. My background is Macedonian, so the owner of Detroit was Macedonian, so we as a family were always Detroit Red Wing fans.
And what better way to finish than a quick shout-out to his horses that bring him such joy?
And let's go, Aardie. Aardie, whoever. Let's go, Aardie. All right, thanks, David. Take care.